All living things share a common ancestor that lived about 4 billion years ago. Phylogenetic trees graphically represent the evolutionary relationships between different organisms. In theory, one should be able to construct a phylogenetic tree describing the relationship between every organism that has ever lived. In practice, however, phylogenetic trees are generally constructed to show the relationships between a limited number of organisms. Phylogenetic trees can also be used to graphically represent the divergence of specific genes within related organisms over time. These phylogenetic trees are known as gene trees. Phylogenetic trees are composed of branches that connect two or occasionally more nodes. There are two kinds of nodes: terminal nodes and internal nodes. The terminal nodes contain the taxa whose evolutionary relationships are being mapped by the phylogenetic tree. Terminal nodes represent organisms that we have data on, including living organisms and fossil evidence of past organisms. Internal nodes are the branch points that represent the point in evolution where organisms at the terminal nodes diverged and represent hypothetical common ancestors for these organisms. There are two kinds of phylogenetic trees: unrooted trees and rooted trees. An unrooted tree is used when the location on the tree of the common ancestor to all the other nodes is not known and specifies only the relationships between nodes on the tree. An unrooted tree therefore says nothing about the evolutionary path that was taken to create the nodes. A rooted tree, by contrast, is a directed tree that has a unique root node that represents the most recent common ancestor of all the other nodes on the tree. An unrooted tree is radial and does not look much like a tree in the literal sense. This is deliberate to avoid implying that we know where the root lies. Yet obviously, any set of taxa has to have some common ancestor. The problem is locating where on the tree we should place the node that represents that ancestor, or the root. We cannot simply choose a midpoint between the two most distantly related taxa, for this would assume that the rate of evolution is the same along all branches, which is often not the case. Therefore, the root for an unrooted tree is often determined through the use of an outgroup. An outgroup is a taxon that, while related to the taxa in the study, has been evolving independent of these other taxa for the longest time. In other words, an outgroup is more distantly related to the other taxa on the tree than these in-group taxa are related to each other, and has clearly branched off earlier than the in-group taxa. Once an outgroup is chosen, placing the root is simple. Since by definition the outgroup branched off earlier, the root node is placed between the outgroup and the node connecting it to the other taxa under study. Once a root is placed, the tree shows graphically what our definition of an outgroup was. The outgroup is not as closely related to the other taxa as they are to one another. Notice that for this unrooted tree containing three terminal nodes or taxa, three different rooted trees can be produced, depending on which group is used for the outgroup. The number of possible trees that can describe the relationship between a set of taxa increases rapidly with the number of taxa under study. Given n taxa under study, the number of possible rooted and unrooted trees can be found with the equations shown. It is quite common for data to be available for 30 or more taxa in modern studies, yet the resulting number of possible trees makes it impossible for even the fastest computers to evaluate them all. Methods are available to narrow the number of trees down to only the most probable ones.
Subscribe to my YouTube channel, The Bio Way, on YouTube, and press the bell icon so that you will never miss another update from my channel. Thank you.